On a fine day of us making a lovely GPT game, suddenly, this screen pops up. We wish they could increase the limit, but life is tough. Luckily, we can reduce the number of nodons so we can add more nodons. This is what we call nodon shaping. This video focuses on the nodon shaping techniques that optimize the number of constant nodons. Let's start with the first technique, summing constants. Here we have many constant nodons. Can we remove one of them? Here you can see that 30 is equal to 10 plus 20. Therefore, you can remove 30 and replace it with the addition of 10 and 20. But can we do better? Which nodon can replace these two constant nodons? Let's begin the second technique, use angle sensor nodon. The angle sensor nodon outputs its angle in the programming screen. So we can change the angle values to match the two constants that we want to replace. In this case, we set x and y values to be 10 and 20. Don't forget to remove visible because we don't want to see wireframe in the game, and make sure that the frame of reference is bold. Now you can replace the first constant with the x output and replace the second constant with the y output of the anchor sensor nodon. Let's look at another example. We have three constant nodons. Can we use x, y, and z anchors to replace these constants? No, because the anchor sensor sometimes does not work when we try to set all three values. In this case, we want 10, 20, and 25. We first set x and y to be 10 and 20. X and y values look correct. Let's try to make z value correct as well. We set z value to be 25. And now look at it. All the values are wrong. So, which nodon can be used to replace three constants? That's the third technique. We are going to use allocation sensor nodon. But how? We need to understand how location sensor works first. Location sensor outputs the x, y, and z position based on its location on the programming screen. So, we can replace the constant values with x, y, and z positions from the location sensor. Let's do it. First, make connections to the location sensor. Second, open the settings. Make sure that it's not visible. Frame of reference must be world. Then, reset x, y, and z positions to be the values that will be replaced. Third, remove the constants. And yay! We can still get those three values, 10, 20, and 25. This makes the game more spaghetti, and we might accidentally move the location sensor, so we should lock it. Additionally, we can change the rotation values to match the position values. With this, we can always check the rotation values and set the position back to match its original values again. Now, let's summarize all the techniques. First, summing constants to get a new value. Second, use the anchor sensor nodon to replace two constants. Third, use the location sensor to replace three constants. To practice using these techniques, let's have a quiz. Can you replace these seven constant nodons with just one nodon? The answer will be in the next video. If you want to know the answer first, join JJ Studio Discord. We also have more nodon shaping techniques for you to explore, and feel free to share your techniques as well. Lastly, I'd love to thank Cert and Mew for helping me with the video, and thank RPG Plus and Cert for sharing these techniques in our Discord. Bye bye, and see you in the next live stream or video. Bye!